In this video, I am going to review the xTool F1. It is a compact and very fast galvo laser engraver which features two different laser sources in one package. It is a versatile laser engraver which can be used to work on almost all types of materials, which eliminates the need of having two machines for engraving small objects. It has a 2-watt infrared laser for engraving metals with amazing detail, and it also has a 10-watt blue diode laser which is excellent for engraving and cutting wood and acrylics. Thanks to its galvo system, it can engrave with amazing speed as it can reach up to 4,000 millimeters per second. In this video, I will put it to the test and show you what this laser is capable of. I will be using it with the optional smoke purifier to see how good it filters out smoke and odors. The machine comes with a very generous sample pack of various materials. You will get a bunch of metal business cards and stainless steel keychains, some black acrylic pieces, two very cool wooden coasters, a slat stone coaster, and some leather tags. You also get some photo paper and two plywood boards. The machine comes packed in a very premium looking box. All the stuff is neatly packed in separate cardboard boxes. The whole unboxing experience is like unboxing a premium smartphone. This part is used like a honeycomb plate, and it helps to get a cleaner cut in plywood. Before we start, let's quickly check out the smoke purifier. It looks very nice. It can be controlled manually, but the F1 supports automatic control of the purifier. It will start automatically when the laser is working. Let's see what's inside. On top of the filter, we find the replaceable pre-filter. You get two spare pre-filters included. And below is the true HEPA filter with activated carbon. The filter is very large and looks to be of high quality. If I shake the filter, you can hear that there is a lot of activated carbon inside, which suggests that it should be very good at removing odors. The laser engraver is very compact and premium looking. The emergency stop switch is conveniently placed on the side of the machine. This knob is used for manual focus adjustment. And the button below is used for enabling the preview function. The machine connects to the computer via USB-C cable or Wi-Fi connection. On the rear side, you will also find a USB locking key which locks the machine if removed, preventing children or unauthorized people from using it. Underneath the machine, you can see the galvo lens in all its glory. The bottom plate can be removed, which enables you to engrave bigger items easily, just by placing the machine on top of them. Connecting the smoke purifier to the laser engraver enables automatic control. The fan in the purifier has three speeds. The lowest speed is used for engraving metals. The highest speed is used when engraving and cutting materials which produce a lot of smoke, like wood and acrylic. First, let's make a quick test to see how the machine works by engraving a metal business card. The focus can be automatically adjusted just by entering the material thickness in the xTool Creative Space software. The machine is in focus when two laser dots align on the surface of the thing you want to engrave. The preview function shows you the exact position of the engraving. This machine is very fast. The machine can be operated by the xTool Creative Space software, but it also supports Lightburn. The xTool Creative Space is free, and I decided to use it as it is easy to use and more than good enough for getting the most out of the xTool F1. It supports all basic functionalities, and it also has a library of more complex shapes like the ones I have used here. Work is organized in layers, where each layer is a different operation. In my case, the red layer uses a fill pattern, and the blue is used for cutting. You can also import your own vector designs. This black part is used instead of the honeycomb bed, and it improves the performance when laser cutting. I left the outlet of the air filter inside my lab to test the air cleaning performance. There is a very faint smell coming out of the outlet, but it is nowhere near as strong as without using the filter. You still want a window open nearby if you are going to do a lot of cutting, but it seems that it filters out 99% of the smell. The filter is very good. Without it, the whole room would be full of smoke. Next, I engraved some black acrylic where I can show you how to use both laser sources in one project. The blue layer is set to engrave with infrared laser. Infrared laser leaves a nice white engraving on black acrylic as we have already seen in my other videos. And the red layer is set for cutting with blue laser. Cutting acrylic produces a very strong and unpleasant smell. But the activated charcoal filter does a very good job. The smell is barely detectable. Without the filter, I would already have a headache. The end result looks very nice and the cut is very clean. Now let's try to engrave a photo. We will use the infrared laser for this purpose as it has a much smaller focus spot size. I will engrave the black paper from the material sample pack. The result is incredible. I really can't believe how good the resolution is. Here is a small anomaly because the paper has moved because of the airflow. Next time I need to weigh it down. Now it's time to test its maximum speed by engraving this vector design of an eagle. The drawing is made of thousands of small vector strokes and will be the perfect test for this machine. This time, I will weigh the paper down. The machine is running at its max speed. The video is not sped up. This is the advantage of galvo lasers, because they don't have external moving parts, and therefore, they can be very precise at blazing fast speed. The result is amazing, and it took only 27 seconds to complete. xTool also sells a lot of materials and items that can be engraved. I got these metallic necklaces to test if the xTool F1 is good at engraving jewelry. The result is once again, very good. The engravings on metal are permanent, but of course not as deep compared to stuff engraved with fiber lasers which have 10 times the power. Let's try to make something cool with this wooden coaster. You can change the preview from rectangular to the actual outline, which comes in handy for round objects. Thanks to its fully enclosed design, it is safe to observe the engraving process without laser goggles. If you would engrave with the lid open, then you must wear quality laser goggles. I found a very good and affordable pair of goggles that I use regularly. Check the link in the video description. Some materials like this slate stone coaster can be engraved with both laser beams. I have set up two identical engravings, one to be engraved with blue laser, and the other one with infrared laser to see the difference between them. The infrared laser has smaller focus spot and produces more detailed engraving. In this case, it also has a bit more contrast. Anodized aluminum animal tags can also be engraved with both lasers. My settings weren't optimal. With some tweaking, better results can be achieved in both cases. The infrared laser is also good at engraving white plastics very quickly. This is a great way for engraving phone cases and other electronics to make a customized gift. As we have seen, the infrared laser is also very good at cleaning coins and removing light rust. This is a feature any coin collector would like to have. This machine also supports the connection of some attachments like the slide extension for increasing the working area. It also supports the xTool RA2 rotary chuck attachment. You connect it with this cable to the side port on the machine. The bottom plate needs to be removed and put next to the machine to support the rotary extension. Let's try to engrave this ring. In the software, you just need to enable the cylinder mode and enter the diameter of the object. Be careful, anything longer than the perimeter will start overlapping. Here I would like to notify you about the current sale at xTool. People who order xTool F1, RA2 Pro and Smoke Purifier together until the end of this month can get the slide extension worth $200 for free. Check the link in description. With the RA2 Pro, you can also engrave larger cylinders like this bottle. If you would like to see more projects with this rotary attachment, check out my full review video of this rotary tool. Link in the description. The engraving has removed the paint down to the metal and will not wear off anytime soon. xTool Creative Space also has an AI image generator if you want to engrave some custom designs. Here I have generated some automatic prompts for a quick test. It can also use an existing photo as a source for generating similar images. By registering, you get 500 free points to use for AI image generation. Points can be either purchased or earned with various activities, but you can import images from other sources as a regular image. The result is beautiful.